My name is Bebe. This video is the collaboration with Bible Smith. You can see my channel on the site. Today we're going to read John. John was a son of Amittai and was born in about 663 BC. One day, the word of God came to Jonah. Get up and go to the great city of Nineveh. Announce my duty man against it, because I have how wet its people are. So one day God called Jonah and he said, send the God's news to the Nineveh. Oh. Sorry. But Jonah got up and went in the opposite direction in order to go away from God. He went down to the sea course, to the port of Joppa, where he found a ship leaving to Tarshish. He bought a ticket and went on board, hoping that by going away to the west, he could escape from God. So Jonah didn't obey God. He has left to the upper side what God has set order him to do. He didn't want to go to the city to tell about God. But as the ship was sailing along, suddenly God flung a power wind over the sea, causing violent storm that threatened to send them to the bottom, fearing for their lives. But the storm sailors shout to their gods for help and threw them through cargo overboard to lighten the ship. So God knows everything. He also knows that Jonah was escaping from God. So he sent a big wave, and they were almost going to sink. When the crew cast lots of to see which from them had often the gods and cast the troubled storms, what they did this. John was the task they asked, what have you done to bring this awful storm down us? Jonah answered, I am a Hebrew. I worship God, the God of heaven, who made the sea and the land. He told them that he was running away from God, and sailors picked Jonah up and threw him into the raining sea. And the storm stopped at once. The sailors were awake by God's great power. So when he's told that he was escaping from God, they threw Jonah to the sea. And when Jonah has gone, the storm stopped. Go and arrange for a great fish to swallow Jonah. And Jonah was inside the fish for 3 days and 3 nights. So Jonah didn't obey God, and he have gone into the huge fish. The huge fish swallowed Jonah. Oh no. And he have been there 3 days and night. Jonah prayed to God from inside the fish. He said, I cried out to God in my great trouble, and he answered me. I called you from the word of death, and God, you had heard me. When I had lost all hope, I turned my thoughts once more to you. God, I will offer sacrifice to you with songs and prayers, and I will faithful all my vows, for my salvation comes from you alone. So he was sad because he didn't obey God. What? Then God ordered the fish to spit out Jonah and beat on the beach. And that God spoke to Jonah a second time. Get up and go to the great city of Nineveh and deliver the message of judgment I have given you. This time Jonah obeyed God's command and went to Nineveh, a city so large that it took 3 days to see all. So now, the huge fish has swallowed Jonah, and now he spit it out. So, God said, it was Nineveh, the city, and God said to Jonah that, tell the news what I tell you. Jonah entered the city and he shouted to the crowds, 40 days from now, Nineveh will be destroyed. The people of Nineveh believe God's message, and from the greatest to the least, they decided to go without food and wear sackcloths to show their sorrow. When God saw that they had put a stop to their evil ways, he had mercy on them and didn't cry out the destruction. He had threatened that the people of Nineveh had been saved. He told the news that Nineveh will be destroyed if you don't turn to God. And they turned to God. Yesterday we read the Bible story. Did you enjoy it? Next time we'll read another good story. See you next time. Bye!